Ponte City. Heaven on earth. Live your life in the sky. But that wasn't on my radar at the tender age of 8. What obsessed me was the corbeau from the 47th floor. That was a long, long way to go. My brother Paul and I collected random objects, and we hid them in our room till we were sure the coast was clear. Then we'd throw them one by one over the edge and watch them disappear. We never heard a sound. Did they ever hit the ground? Turns out we weren't the only ones who threw things down there. Eventually the garbage piled up 5 stories high. But by then my folks and I had gone, leaving my optimistic brother who stubbornly stayed on. He wasn't threatened by the new population. He went about his business thinking they would let him be. But when people get too desperate, they lose all sense of decency. They sent him sailing into the car of Ponte, and all they got was maybe 200 rand. They sent him sailing into the car of Ponte. Did anybody hear? Did they watch him disappear? That bold sign is like a blazing reminder, broadcasting over the town. Fixing up the building to sell off the flats for near a million rand apiece. Do you think that that's enough to pay to wash Ponte City's countless sins away? And for some reason I'm compelled to return there to take one final look before they gloss over the past. After sitting on my grief, it's a relief to deal with this at last. I'm gonna sail into the car of Ponte and sail down into that bottomless pit. I'm gonna sail into the car of Ponte and listen for the sound as my feet touch. I'm certain that he is somehow